My dear brothers and sisters, Allah Jalla wa Ala is just. وَلَا يَظْلِمُ رَبُّكَ أَحَدًا. There is no justice except it is coming from Allah Jalla wa Ala. And we know that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sahbihi wa sallam said, لَا فَضْلَ لِعَرَبِيٍّ عَلَىٰ عَجَمِيٍّ إِلَّا بِالتَّقْوَى. There is no superiority of a person over another person, even an Arab over a non-Arab, except by taqwa. And there are many evidences that confirm that the people are equal before Allah Jalla wa Ala. And Allah Jalla wa Ala opened the Jannah, the Jinan, for all of us. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sahbihi wa sallam said in one hadith, رُبَّ أَشْعَثَ أَغْبَرْ مَطْمُورٍ مَدْفُوعٍ بِالْأَبْوَابِ لَا يُعْبَهُ لَهُ لَوْ أَقْسَمَ عَلَى اللَّهِ لَأَبَرَّ. You might find a person who is poor, devastated. People do not respect him with uncombed hair, uniironed clothes, maybe very cheap clothes. A person who is simple, who thinks that he is nothing. Let me say that again. He thinks that he is what? Nothing. How many people, my dear brothers and sisters, they think that they are nothing? Why? Maybe because they are laborers, maybe laborers, maybe they are poor in terms of money, maybe they don't have a status, maybe they don't have a position in the society, maybe they are maybe disabled, they might have some other limitations. So they think that they are nothing. And they look up to maybe rich people, people with high status, people maybe with some skills. They think that they are the best people in the dunya and the best people in the akhirah. Allah Jalla wa Ala said, no, this is not the skill. This is not my skill. My skill is what? Taqwa. Taqwa. That's why if we look at the Quran and survey the Quran, we see that Allah Jalla wa Ala opened the door for all of us to compete for the akhirah. وَسَارِعُوا إِلَى مَغْفِرَةٍ مِّن رَبِّكُمْ سَابِقُوا إِلَى مَغْفِرَةٍ مِّن رَبِّكُمْ وَجَنَّةٍ عَرْضُهَا كَعَرْضِ السَّمَاءِ وَالْأَرْضِ. He addressed all of us, compete, be quick to what? To the Jannah, which is open for all of us, my dear brothers and sisters. So the principle in Islam that we are all have equal opportunities to excel and to have the highest status in Jannah. And there is no room for anyone to say that I am nothing. And in fact, those who believe that they are humble and they do not have a status, big status, they might have a bigger opportunity to win on the day of resurrection. So the bottom line, my dear brothers and sisters, is don't belittle yourself. Don't belittle what you can do. The Jannah, as we said, is open for all of us. The highest place in Jannah is given to those who work hard, not to those who have a certain lineage, not to those who are rich, not to those who have certain status, not to those who are known among the people. As simple as this. But what can I do? I am a single person. I don't have a big amount of money. Maybe I don't have a status. What can I do? My dear brothers and sisters, many of us think that Allah Jalla wa Ala holds us accountable according to what we achieve in this dunya. So the rich people can spend more, so they have a bigger chance to get a higher place in Jannah. Some people think that the leaders, they can achieve better than us because they are leaders and they can get higher places in Jannah. A group of poor people heard, or a group of poor people came to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam and said, Ya Rasulallah, ذَهَبَ أَهْلُ الدُّثُورِ بِالْأُجُورِ. The rich people got all the reward. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, why? Then they said, Ya Rasulallah, Ya Rasulallah. They pray, we pray. They pray, we pray. And they have surplus, they have some amount of money, so they can go for jihad, they can go for hajj, they can give sadaqah, and we don't have that. And the response of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam was amazing. He said, shall I tell you about something that you will catch up with them? Then they said, really, ya Rasulullah? Then the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, تسبحون الله وتحمدون الله وتكبرون الله. After each salah, 33 times, or in one narration, 25 times. Then the rich people heard about this. They said, are we going to leave this opportunity to the poor people? No. Allah Jalla wa Ala says, وَفِي ذَلِكَ فَلْيَتَنَافَسِ الْمُتَنَافِسُونَ إِنَّ الْأَبْرَارَ لَفِي نَعِيمٍ على الأرائك ينظرون تعرف في وجوههم نظرة النعيم يسقون من رحيق مختوم ختامه مسك وفي ذلك فليتنافس المتنافسون. Life is nothing but a competition between all of us. So the rich people, when they heard about the virtues of tasbih and tahmid and takbir after the salah, they said, we shall do that again. Look what happened to the poor people. They went back to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam and said, ya Rasulullah, look what happened. The rich people heard about this and they are now doing it. So now we have no virtue over them. We have no advantage over them. They know this. Then the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, this is the fadl of Allah jalla wa ala. This is the bounty of Allah jalla wa ala. Allah jalla wa ala grants it to whom he wills or he wishes jalla wa ala. The point is, what, my dear brothers and sisters, there is a huge room for all of us. For the person who is the caretaker of the masjid, the person who is very poor, the person who is working for the king, the person who is working as a cleaner, the engineer, the doctor, the businessman, the lawyer, the politician, there is a room for all of us to compete for our akhirah. So don't belittle yourself at all. Allah Jalla wa Ala told us about the story, which I always like to quote, a very rich story. The story of the people of the town, mentioned in Surah Yasin. Allah Jalla wa Ala sent to them two prophets, and then still they did not believe in those two prophets. Allah Jalla wa Ala sent another prophet to them. وَاضْرِبْ لَهُمْ مَثَلًا أَصْحَابَ الْقَرْيَةِ إِذْ جَاءَهَا الْمُرْسَلُونَ إِذْ أَرْسَلْنَا إِلَيْهِمْ اثْنَيْنِ فَكَذَّبُوهُمَا فَعَزَّزْنَا بِثَالِثٍ. We sent two prophets, still they denied them, and we sent them a third prophet. Still they did not believe. Allah Jalla wa Ala said, وَجَاءَ مِنْ أَقْصَى الْمَدِينَةِ رَجُلٌ يَسْعَى قَالَ يَا قَوْمِ اتَّبِعُوا الْمُرْسَلِينَ. This person is nothing, he is not a prophet. He's not a scholar. He's not a big man. He's not a leader. He's not a king. He is not. Allah Jalla wa Ala said, وَجَاءَ رَجُلٌ. It doesn't matter what status he has in this dunya. And this person said, what? يَا قَوْمِ اتَّبِعُوا الْمُرْسَلِينَ. My people, listen to the prophets. اتَّبِعُوا مَنْ لَا يَسْأَلُكُمْ أَجْرًا وَهُمْ مُهْتَدُونَ وَمَا لِيَ لَا أَعْبُدُ الَّذِي فَطَرَنِي وَإِلَيْهِ تُرْجَعُونَ. How can I don't worship the one who created me? And then at the end, Allah Jalla wa Ala says, قِيلَ ادْخُلِ الْجَنَّةِ. It was said to him, yes, go to Jannah. قَالَ يَا لَيْتَ قَوْمِي يَعْلَمُونَ بِمَا غَفَرَ لِي رَبِّي وَجَعَلَنِي مِنَ الْمُكْرَمِينَ. Look at this. Yes, because of this, Allah Jalla wa Ala granted him a status in Jannah that he wished all his people to share with, or to share him with, which means that he got a very good status in Jannah. Subhanallah. He never belittled himself. He never said, I'm not a prophet, I'm nothing, what can I do? Yes, three prophets, they did nothing. No, my dear brothers and sisters, Allah Jalla wa Ala doesn't look at this. Allah Jalla wa Ala looks at your ability versus your effort. Please let us remember this equation. The ability versus what? Versus the effort. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said in one hadith, سَبَقَ دِرْهَمٌ مِعَةَ أَلْفَ دِرْهَمٌ. A one rial of sadaqah might be better than 100,000 riyals of sadaqah. How? The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, a person has 2 riyals, 2 dirhams. Yeah? Yani like 2 riyals. He gave one of them as sadaqah, and the other person is so rich, he just grabbed from his money. Yes, and it happened that this is 100,000 dirhams or riyals. Now, who achieved more? According to our maybe calculations and our standards, the person who gave 100,000 riyals has given what? More, and more people have benefited from him. Yes, because this is according to our standards. But the Prophet ﷺ said, no, the riyal might be better than the 100,000 riyals. How? Because the person who gave 1 riyal, he has given, in fact, what? 50% of his wealth. So his ability versus what? Versus the effort. How much he had and how much effort he had put, not how much he was given. So that's why Allah Jalla wa Ala does not hold accountable the leader as he holds accountable the cleaner. The cleaner, he has a lighter hisab, and the leader has a bigger hisab. So the cleaner has more chances to what? To win in Jannah. So don't belittle yourself. Subhanallah. In the Quran, we read also in the story of Musa. Allah Jalla wa Ala said about the story of Musa, when the people were plotting to kill Musa alayhi salam, again, وَجَاءَ رَجُلٌ مِنْ أَقْصَى الْمَدِينَةِ قَالَ يَا مُوسَى إِنَّ الْمَلَأَ يَأْتَمِرُونَ بِكَ لِيَقْتُلُوكَ. He saved the Prophet Musa just by what? A simple statement. He went to Musa and he said, Musa, be careful. They are plotting to kill you. So Musa, the prophet who is among the main prophets, yes, Musa alayhi salam was saved because of a statement from what? From a just a normal person who might be one of you, who might think that he is nothing. And look, subhanallah, the story of Sulaiman alayhi salam. حَتَّى إِذَا أَتَوْا عَلَى وَادِ النَّمْلِ قَالَتْ نَمْلَةٌ يَا أَيُّهَا النَّمْلُ ادْخُلُوا مَسَاكِنَكُمْ لَا يَحْطِمَنَّكُمْ سُلَيْمَانُ وَجُنُودُهُ وَهُمْ لَا يَشْعُرُونَ. The story of Sulaiman with his army, a big army, they were going for an expedition. And then when they were walking, they were about to step over the houses of the ants. I don't know what they are called. One ant, one single ant, not known, not known. Did she belittle herself and said, what can I do to save my people? I can do nothing. This is Sulaiman and his army. Just she used one statement. She said, Ayyuhan Naml, oh ants, be careful. Sulaiman is coming. Go down so you will not be killed by the army of Sulaiman and they are not aware of you, because they are not aware of you. So she saved her people just because of what? Because of a simple statement. Did she or did it belittle herself or itself? No, not at all, not at all. We know the story of the Hudhud. The Hudhud, when he went to Sulaiman alayhi salam, the bird. Yes, when Sulaiman alayhi salam checked the bird and he said, where is the Hudhud? I don't see him. And then the Hudhud all of a sudden came and said, oh Sulaiman, yes, جِئْتُكَ مِنْ سَبَعٍ بِنَبَعٍ يَقِينٍ إِنِّي وَجَدْتُ امْرَأَ I came to you from Saba, yes, the kingdom of Saba. And he mentioned that they used to be kuffar. طيب, أَلَّا يَسْجُدُوا لِلَّهِ. They were not prostrating before Allah Jalla wa Ala. As a result of this, subhanallah, my dear brothers and sisters, Sulaiman alayhi salam sent to them a da'wah. And then the da'wah came to their queen, and then the queen came to Sulaiman, and as a result of this, the whole of Saba people, big nation, they accepted Islam, and who knows who is now Muslim because of their ancestors, and in fact, all of them became Muslims because of what? Because of the Hudhud. He never belittled itself. Again, my dear brothers and sisters, the message is what? Don't ever belittle yourself. Allah Jalla wa Ala told us about the story of Maryam. Because Allah Jalla wa Ala wants to address women as well. Allah Jalla wa Ala doesn't, Allah Jalla wa Ala, as we said, gave opportunities for everyone. Male, female, young, old, rich, king, cleaner, leader, for all of us. Allah Jalla wa Ala told us about the story of Maryam and her mother. Her mother, she wanted to have children, and she wanted to have a child who will be a servant of Bayt al-Maqdis. قالت ربي إني نذرت لك ما في بطني محررة فتقبله مني. She wants to do the minimum. And in fact, it is the maximum for in the sight of Allah Jalla wa Ala. Many of our sisters, my dear brothers and sisters, she thinks that she has to have a big career. She has to be a big doctor, a big engineer, in order for herself to compete with men, in order for herself to prove that women can do something. And they belittle the role of mothers. They belittle the role of mothers. And they don't know that the role of a mother is the best role in this life. The most important job is the job of the mother. The most important job. It is not the most important. It is not the job of the leader or of the king or of the emir. It is the job of who? The mother. So why many sisters belittle their role? So the mother of Maryam, she wanted to have a child in order to what? That child serves Bayt al-Maqdis because this is the maximum that she can do. Allah Jalla wa Ala, as a result of this, gave her what? Because he knew of her intention, gave her who? Maryam. Who is Maryam? The mother of who? Of one of the great prophets. So the mother of Maryam, when she gave birth to Maryam, قالت ربي إني وضعتها أنثى وليس الذكر كالأنثى. Allah wants to teach her a lesson, because she thought that, yeah, look, this is a female, and the female is not going to do jihad. She's not going to be one of the leaders. She's not going to do something big, and also she's not going to serve Bayt al-Maqdis. So she thought that she has not achieved much. And then Maryam, what? Became the mother of Isa. Allah Jalla wa Ala called her. She is the only lady mentioned in the Quran as the Siddiqa. Yes? وَأُمُّهُ صِدِّيقَ كَانَ يَأْكُلَانِ الطَّعَامِ. The mother of Isa. Moreover, even with Maryam alayha salam, even with Maryam alayha salam, Allah Jalla wa Ala wants to tell us a lesson that you need to do what you can do, even if you think that it is minimum. So when Maryam alayhi salam became pregnant with Isa, yes, and she said, Ya laytani mittu qabla hada wa kuntu nasyan mansiya. She was in a very terrible situation, because her people will accuse her of what? Of fornication, of zina. So she went, and she was about to give birth. Allah Jalla wa Ala told her, he wants to teach her, to teach us, to teach the whole humanity, that do whatever you can do, the maximum you can do, and I will help you. Yes? وَهُزِّي إِلَيْكِ بِجِذْعِ النَّخْلَةِ تُسَاقِطْ عَلَيْكِ رُطَبًا جَنِيًّا. Maryam, now you are in a terrible situation, and you need to have some food, and you need to relax, etc., etc. All what you need to do is just shake the trunk of the tree, and soft dates will drop on you. Maryam never said, Ya Allah, how can I do this? I am a very weak woman in this devastated situation. She did that, and Allah Jalla wa Ala relieved her from the pain. Don't belittle yourself, and don't belittle what you can do, my dear brothers and sisters. That's why the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam also said, لا تحقرن من المعروف شيئا ولو أن تلقى أخاك بوجه طلق. Don't belittle any amount of good deeds that you may do. Even if you meet your brother in a smiley, cheerful face. In the other hadith, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, اتقوا النار ولو بشق تمرة. Put a shield between you and the fire of hell. How? How? By what? By giving one date as a sadaqah. It might be the shield between you and the hellfire. And also the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said to women, don't belittle anything you can do, even if you give your neighbor some of the food or soup that you have cooked. That might be the reason to help you on the day of resurrection. My dear brothers and sisters, we can talk a lot about this important principle in Islam, which is what every single one of us has a role to play. Every single one of us, what? Has a role to play in the society, in the ummah, in raising up the status of the ummah. And subhanallah, we need every single effort. The ummah needs every single effort. Don't sit just like this and you are bothered about nothing. No, no. That's why the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sahbihi wa sallam said, what? من رأى منكم منكرا فليغيره بيده فإن لم يستطع فبلسانه فإن لم يستطع فبقلبه. If you see something wrong, try to change it by your hand. If you can't, then by your tongue. If you can't, then by your heart. And this is the weakest position of iman. Which means what? Which means do something. Don't accept to see wrong things around you and you just sit and watch because you belittle yourself. You think that you are nothing. No. Every single one has something to do. In the other hadith, which is amazing hadith, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, "Kullu sulama, kullu sulama min al-mar'i kull yawmin tatla'u fihi ash-shamsi 'alayhi sadaqa." Kullu sulama means, in brief, every single joint. Yes, every single joint you have to give a sadaqa for it. Subhanallah. In one narration, Abu Dhakar said, "Ya Rasulullah, how can we do that? We don't have money to do that." Then the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sahbihi wasallam said, ta'adilu bayna thnayni sadaqah. You reconcile between two people who have a conflict is a sadaqah. You help a person to ride his camel is a sadaqah. You left his goods is a sadaqah. And amrun bil ma'roof sadaqah. Enjoining the good is a sadaqah. Forbidding the evil is a sadaqah. In the other hadith, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, wa kullu tasbihatin sadaqah, wa kullu tahmidatin sadaqah, wa kullu tahlilatin sadaqah. Every single tasbih or tahmid or tahlil is a sadaqah. Do something, my dear brothers and sisters. Do something, and in conclusion, never belittle yourself. Wallahi, you can do a lot. And Allah jalla wa ala is so generous. And Allah jalla wa ala promised all of us, إِنَّ اللَّهَ لَا يُضِيعُ أَجْرَ مَنْ أَحْسَنَ عَمَلًا. Any single thing that you do, Allah جل وعلا will not let it go waste. In fact, Allah جل وعلا received it in His right hand and increases that for you. So you see it when you really need every single hasana on the day of resurrection. Don't belittle yourself, my dear brothers and sisters.